Good morning everyone, this is Indra. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video I am going to solve a problem related with three figure bearing as well as the scaling. Here I have taken one question. First of all, let me read the question. An aeroplane travels 80 km, first travels 80 km on the bearing of 60 degree here. The bearing is 060 degree. It is three figure bearing. It is written here in three digits format. So it is the three figure bearing. First travels 80 km on the bearing of 060 degree. And then another 120 km on the bearing of 95 degree. This is also three figure bearing. First travels 80 km on the bearing of 60 degree and then travels 120 km on the bearing of 95 degree. Then we have to show the information in the drawing. We have to make a drawing by using this information. And using the suitable scale, we can use here the scale. Here the data are largest data. Here the length is 80 km. We cannot draw 80 km long line on the paper. So we have to reduce the size. We have to do the scaling here. That is called as the scaling. By using the concept of scaling, we can resize the length. We can resize the length with this. This is the question. And in question number A, first, how far is the aeroplane from the starting point? And the B is find the bearing of the last point from the starting point. And here the note is given here. You can use the protractor. We can use the protractor to measure the angle here. Okay. First of all, the solution is here written. First of all, let's suppose the point A. A refers to the starting point. Starting point is just the point A. And the B point. Point B is the second point. Here are the three points. The first A is the starting point, B is the second point, and the next point is the C is the last point. It is the final destination point. These are the assumptions. And bearing of this point B from the point A is here 060 degree. Bearing of the point B. First travels from the point A to B, and the bearing of that point B from A is here 60 degree. And then from B travels 120 km to the point C. So the bearing of the point C from B is here 95 degree. Okay. And here the length is so much large, 80 km. So we have to scaling. We have to do the scaling for it. And taking the scale of here, we have taken the scale of 1 centimeter is to 20 km. This means 1 centimeter is equivalent to the 20 kilometer. We can take 1 centimeter for the 20 kilometer. So let's find out in 80 kilometer how many 20 kilometers. So we have to divide here 80 divided by 20, and there will be the 4 in centimeter unit. So we can draw the 4 centimeter line instead of 80 kilometer line. This is called as the scaling. By taking the scale of 1 centimeter is to 20 kilometer. Similarly, next line is BC here. BC is just 120 divided by 20. That will be just the value 6 in centimeter unit. Okay, here we have just taken this scale. 1 centimeter is equivalent to 20 kilometer, and we have converted these kilometers measurements into the corresponding centimeter measurement by using the same scale. Okay, let's draw this information. Let me use the GeoGebra software. I will draw that information. Okay, first of all, let's memorize this information. A is the starting point, B is the second point, and the C is the last point. And the first bearing is here given as the 60 degree, second is 95 degree. And the first centimeter is 4 centimeter. Okay, let me just draw. Let me use the GeoGebra software. Okay, this is the GeoGebra software, one which we can draw. Okay, first of all, let's take the starting point at the point A. Okay, let me take the point A here. This is just the point A. And let's find out. This is just the point A. And let me give a line for the horizontal surface. Okay, this is just the horizontal line. Okay. And here the point B. Here I have just first taken the point A, point A is the starting point, and I have just drawn the horizontal line here. The horizontal line will help us to make the angle very accurately. Okay, this is just the horizontal surface, and this is the point A. It is the starting point. According to our assumption, we have already assumed that the point A is the starting point. And from this point A, next point B is defined. Next point is defined is the second point at the bearing of 60 degree. The first bearing is 60 degree. Okay, first of all, let me, and please remember that, all of you please remember that, the three figure bearing is always measured from the north pole in clockwise direction. So we have to mark the north pole here. North pole will be the exactly perpendicular to the surface, to the horizontal line. Okay, let me make the perpendicular line here. Perpendicular line passes through this point A and perpendicular to this line. Okay, this line. Okay, let me rename this line as the N. N means the north line. Okay. Here, this line N represents the north pole. This is just the north pole, which is exactly 90 degree with this line, with this horizontal line. Okay, this is just the north pole. And the bearing, let me go to the question once again. Here, in the question, first point, first A is the starting point, and the bearing of the point B, point B from A is here 60 degree. So we have to make an angle of 60 degree with the north pole in clockwise direction. Then there will be the point B. And the point B will be located 4 centimeter from the point A. Okay, let me first make an angle of 60 degree with the north pole in clockwise direction. Okay, let me just make an angle. Let's make an angle of 60 degree. First bearing is 060 degrees, so we have to make the angle 60 degree with this north pole in clockwise direction, just the 60 degree angle. Okay. Let me here. This is a 60 degree in clockwise directions with the north pole. Okay, and this point B dash. Okay, let me just I will rename the points. First of all, let me just make. Okay. And let me just make the line here. And this line is exactly at the 60 degree, this line. And let me rename this point, and we can okay, let me just rename these points. This is not the B dash point. This is just this will be just the point B. Okay, this is just the point B, and let me hide this point Y. Okay, this point B is this line is located at the 60 degree with the north pole in clockwise directions. And here the point B. Okay, let me just and the point B. Okay, let's find out the location, exact location of the point B. So point B is the second position, second point. Okay, let me go to the question once again. Here in the question, the point B. Okay, aeroplane travels 80 kilometer on the bearing of 60 degree. Okay, the point B is located at the 80 kilometer from the point A, and the 80 kilometer corresponds to the 4 centimeter by using this scale. 4 centimeter. So for finding the point B, we have to go 4 centimeter from the point A. Okay, let me just find out the point location of exact location of the point B. Okay, this is the bearing line, which is this is the line inclined at the 60 degree bearing with the north pole in clockwise direction. So okay, let me use the circle tool, circle with the center and radius. Let's say this is the center and the radius value is 4 centimeter. You have to go 4 centimeter from this point A. Okay, and here we have just made the circle. Let me mark that intersection point, point of the intersections of this line and the circle. That will be just the point B. Okay, let me rename this. This is here shown is the point C. Okay, let me just rename this is the point B. And here I think the point B is already defined here anyway. Okay. Let me just rename this as the point W, and the point B will be defined. Okay, let me just the point. This is just the point B. Okay, this is the exact location of the point B. Let me hide this circle. Okay, we can hide this circle. Okay, here we have just find out the exact location of this second point B, which is at the 4 centimeter from this point A, 4 centimeter cross poles to the 80 kilometer. Okay. 4 kilometer from this point A, and this line is an angle of 60 degree with the north pole in clockwise directions. That is just the bearing. Okay, here we have just find out the location of this point B, and let me go to the questions once again. And here we have just fulfilled the first statement. Then another 120 kilometer corresponds to 6 centimeter, 120 kilometer on the bearing of 95 degree. Okay, let me just start. 120 kilometer on the bearing of 95 okay 95 degree okay not in kilometer 120 kilometer on the bearing of 95 degree. Okay, let's make the 95 degree bearing at the point B. Okay, let me just open that software one. And at this point B, we have to make 95 degree bearing. Okay, so first of all, let me mark the north pole at this point B. Okay, this is just the line. Okay, let me rename the line. It is the line H. Let me rename this is the N dash. Okay, this N dash. Okay, N dash. N prime represents this N. Okay, here is the not N prime. Okay, let me just rename this is the N dash. Okay, this N dash represents the another north pole, and we are going to make an angle of 95 degree, an angle of 95 degree with this north pole in clockwise direction. Okay, let me make an angle of 95 degree with this north pole, just 95 degree. Okay, 95 degree, 95 degree in clockwise directions with the north pole. Okay, this point C dash. Okay, let me just connect these points. Let me just connect. Okay, this let me hide the unnecessary parts here. So this is just the 95 degree, and this is just the C dash is here shown. This is let me hide this first in the name of these vectors also. Okay. Shoe level of turn of the shoe level. Okay, and we have behind this point C. Okay, here we have just made the end of bearing of 95 degree. Okay, and okay, this is just the bearing of 90 degrees. And let's find out the destination point, point C. And let me go to the questions once again. Point C, let's find out the point C. Point C, another 120 kilometer from that point B. The location of the point C is at the 120 kilometer from the point B. 120 kilometer corresponds to the 6 centimeter. Okay, 6 centimeter. Okay, let's go 6 centimeter from the point B to find the point C. Okay, let me take the circle with the radius 6 centimeter in the center at this point B. Okay, 6 centimeter, just 6 centimeter, and then that point of the intersections. Point of the intersections will be the point C. Okay, let me find out the point of the intersection. Okay, so let me rename here. This is just the point C. Let me rename just the point. Point C is already defined here. Okay. Okay, let me just define the last point is the point C. Okay, let me replace this B point as the point C. Okay, this is just the point C. Let me hide these unnecessary circles. Okay. This is just the point C, which is at the 6 centimeter from this point B. And here we have finally obtained the destination point. The starting point is here, point A, and the destination point is point C, and the second point is here, point B. Okay, let me just connect these points A and C. Starting point, let me use the segment tool. Okay, starting point and these end points. Side the label. Okay, here and let me hide unnecessary parts of these drawings. Okay. Let me use the vector tools here. From A to B first, and then B to U and B. Okay, let me just remove the vector U and B. I'm just going to hide unnecessary parts of these drawings. This is the, which is the line G. Okay, let me remove this line G, and this is which line? Yes, line. Okay, is it okay? Let me hide this ray as and the line G also. Okay. Let me just hide. And let me hide the horizontal lines also. Okay, this is okay. Here we have just here from this starting point A, we have just moved to the 4 centimeter. At an angle of 60 degree, in a bearing of 60 degree, and then we will find out the next point B. And from that point B, from that second point B, we have just moved 95 degree at 6 centimeter, okay, length, at the 6 centimeter length. And finally, we have reached to this point C. And let me go to the questions once again. Yeah, the question is, how far is the airplane from the starting point? We need the length of starting point A and the ending point C. AC, length of the AC. Okay, let me just measure the length of AC. Okay, let me just measure the AC. Okay, let me just measure the AC and just by clicking and go to the setting and show value. We have to do the show value, show level. Okay, just the value. Okay, it is just the 9.55 in centimeter. Sorry, let me do once again just by clicking this and go to the setting and show level is the value, and the value is here shown 9.55 centimeter. This is just 9.55 centimeter. It is in centimeter, but our original question is in kilometer, so we have to change the centimeter in kilometer, and we have already taken a scale there. It is just 9.55. okay, let me go to the questions once again. Yeah, scale is just 1 centimeter represents 20 kilometers. So 9.55 centimeter, we can calculate that. 9.55 centimeter, how much? Let me use the calculator here. For the 9.55 centimeter, we have to do the multiplication. 9.55 centimeter corresponds to 9.55 times 20 kilometer. This will be just 191 in kilometer. So we can say that. How far is the aeroplane from the starting point? The aeroplane is at the 190 kilometer from the starting point. Okay, we have just changed the scale here from centimeter to kilometer. Just 191 kilometer. Okay, let's let me go to the drawing once again. And the second question, let me read the question second. Find the bearing of the last point from the starting point. Okay, let me let's find out the bearing of the point C from the point A. Bearing of this point C from A is just the N angle with the north pole, with the north pole in clockwise direction. Okay, let me measure the angle. Let me measure the angle made by this AC with the north pole. Okay, with the north pole in clockwise directions. Okay, let me measure. Let me just measure. Angle tool, and selecting this line and next line. Okay, here the angle is shown how much degree? 81.68 degree. Here the angle is just nearly 82 degree. Angle is given, angle is shown here. That means the point, the bearing of this point C from the point A is 081 degree. We have to write in three figures, so 081. And let's round off to the whole number. It is just 82 degree. So the bearing of this point C from point A is just 082 degree in three digits. Okay, 082 degree. This is just the true bearing. Here we have just often 82 degree. The bearing of this point C from point A is 082 degree. Okay, here we have just solved these questions, and this is the final answer of this question. Let me go to the questions once again. Here we have just solved these questions A and B. So the find the bearing of the last point, it is just here often is the 82 in degree. In our next video, we will discuss more about such types of the questions. So keep watching, keep loving this channel, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. And if you have any feedbacks to this channel, you can comment your feedbacks on the comment box below. This much for today. Thank you.